Certainly, electrical harmonics, both in voltage and current, have nowadays become into a parameter whose control and management becomes essential if we want to prevent and avoid the possible troubles that they may cause if they are present in our power system. Anyway, first of all, let me introduce myself. I'm Josep García Fàbrega, product manager in the power quality division in Circutor, mainly dealing with power factor correction systems and harmonic filtering. And my today aim is to start a series of three videos where we are going to talk about electrical harmonics to increase your knowledge about them, basically focusing on their definition, the main problems that they may cause, and of course, possible troubleshooting actions. Let's begin by defining what harmonics are. To do this, we are going to go back in time at the early 19th century when a French mathematician called Jean-Baptiste Fourier developed a theory that demonstrated that any periodical wave can be represented by the sum of simple, pure waves with different amplitudes and frequencies that are called harmonics. This definition probably sounds a little bit tricky, but with the following example, for sure, it would be much easier to be understood. Let's assume that the wave on the screen stands for the current wave in a 15 Hz network. This means that this wave happens 50 times in 1 second, so it has a time amplitude of 20 milliseconds. In a 60 Hz network, the time amplitude would be of 16.6 milliseconds. This is what we call the fundamental wave. And now we are going to superpose a wave with a frequency 5 times higher. So it means that within these 20 milliseconds, this wave is repeated 5 times. So we are talking about the 5th harmonic. This superposition will result in the waveform you can see now in the screen. And now let's complicate this a little bit more. We are going to superpose a 7th order wave. So a wave with a frequency of 350 or 420 Hz, depending on 15 or 16 Hz. Which is now the resulting waveform, the one you can see on the screen. This waveform is the one that we will really measure with an oscilloscope, and is the one that normally we will measure at the input of a standard variable speed drive. It is nicknamed here in Circutor like the M from McDonald's. So we can more or less approximately conclude that a standard variable speed drive generates a current wave that can be decomposed into the fundamental and mainly the 5th and the 7th harmonic. So we can establish a first division of the electrical loads between those consuming a fundamental current that we are going to call linear loads, normally induction motors, poor resistive loads, and those loads that, besides of consuming the fundamental load, they are also consuming harmonic currents. We are going to refer to them like non-linear or distorting loads. These loads are normally variable speed drives, rectifiers, single-phase electronic loads, LED lighting. In the end, any kind of load that converts AC into DC for their operation. Another key point is how to evaluate the harmonic content in our power system. For this purpose, we are going to use the harmonic decomposition or spectrum, that is the magnitude of each harmonic frequency. So if we mainly have three-phase nonlinear loads, the typical harmonic that we are going to find are the 5th, the 7th, the 11th, and the 13th, in this following order of importance. Whereas in four-wire systems with a huge number of single-phase loads connected between phases and the neutral, we're going to find also the triplet harmonics, basically the 3rd, the 9th, and 15th. And now the predominant one is going to be the 3rd. To assess the harmonic level in our power systems, we typically use the total harmonic distortion rates, known with the acronym THD. THDU for the voltage, THDI for the current. These rates indicate the percentage of the RMS value of the harmonics in relation to the fundamental one. And this range should help us to evaluate the severity of the harmonic contained in our installation so that we can decide whether any kind of corrective action is required to be applied. So far, I've been essentially talking about current harmonics. In the end, nonlinear loads are the ones generating current harmonics. But what happened with the voltage? Obviously, voltage harmonics also exist in our installation. In fact, the current harmonics running through the cables in the power system generate harmonic voltage drops that give rise to a harmonic distortion in voltage. So anytime that we have to analyze our power system in terms of harmonic, we have to always consider both harmonic rates for the voltage and the current. Otherwise, we could reach wrong conclusion that may mislead to the solution to be applied. And to finish this first session, let's look at another key point of harmonic. This is their phase sequence. As you can see, some harmonics has a positive sequence, like the seventh. Other has a negative sequence, like the fifth. Another has a zero sequence. They are known homopolar harmonics, which are basically the triplet harmonics. And they are the cause of one of the main troubles related with harmonics in four-wire systems, as we will see in the next video. But don't worry, I'm not going to spoil it for you. So I look forward to meeting you at the next episode to figure out what happens with homopolar harmonics in addition with other troubles related with harmonics. Till then, good luck and stay safe.